Hi, hello and welcome to my channel. Hope all are doing good. Like, share, subscribe and click on the bell icon for the latest notification of the upcoming videos. Do watch and comment the videos. So we are into the topic of percentage. We have seen the basics of percentage, then how to use shortcuts, tips and tricks to solve percentage simplification, etc. And understand the concept that percentage is not only a separate topic but is also combined with other topics. Like, we use percentage in profit and loss, selling price, cost price, work, then speed, distance, time, mensuration, date and presentation. Everywhere we use percentage. So once we are thorough with the basics of percentage, we can use the shortcuts to easily crack these kind of questions. Okay, so today we'll see some application problems. Okay, first we will understand the concept using formula and then we'll go into the shortcut. Okay, so that you can crack the questions very easily. Okay, now let us see the first question. See, if salary of Mr. A is 20% greater than Mr. B, then Mr. B's salary is how much percentage lesser than Mr. A? See, on the very first time when we hear this question, we'll think it is very easy, right? 20% greater than B. So obviously B would be 20% lesser than A. But that is a wrong concept because percentage is different and a number is different. See, 20% greater than B, okay? So we'll get a value. From that, how much is lesser on percentage calculation? So the value differs, okay? So the formula for it is, see, if A is R percentage more than B, then B is less than A by what percentage? When you have that question, we will use the formula R by, R is nothing but the increase, okay? R by 100 plus R, again the increase into 100, okay, percentage. If A is R percentage less than B, then B is more than A by R by 100 minus R into 100 percentage. So this is the formula method. See, on substituting, we get R is here 20. 20 by 100 plus R, which is 20 into 100 percentage, which on calculation is 20 by 120 into 100, which is 1 by 6 into 100. We already have seen fraction into percentage. 1 by 6 is nothing but 16.66 percentage. Okay, this is how we have to use formula. But this will take, definitely this will take much time. So the shortcut is, just always convert the given percentage into fraction. The given percentage is 20. 20 in fraction is 1 by 5. Hope you remember. So it is greater they have given. So put an up arrow near to it. Okay. Then equal to. Always keep the numerator same. Okay. So just copy the numerator to right hand side, which is 1. Okay. Now add the denominator and numerator. Since left hand side it is up arrow, there is an increase. So add. So 5 plus 1 is 6. Write it in denominator. Now it is a decrease, right? So 1 by 6 percentage decrease, which is, 1 by 6 decrease, which is 16.66 percentage. See, one step answer. This is the shortcut. We'll see one more question, so I'll get used to it. See, journalist Popatlal's weight is 37.5 percentage less than Dr. Iyer's. Okay. Then Dr. Iyer's weight is how much percentage more than Popatlal's weight? Okay. See, the same question here, instead of salary, they have given us weight. Okay. So 37.5 percentage. Remember, this is a table following 12.5. 12.5 where we have seen where denominator is 8. So it is 3 by 8. Okay. 3 by 8. Here it is decrease. So less than, right? So downwards arrow, which is equal to. Just copy the numerator as such. Okay. Since it is decrease, we will have to subtract. So 8 minus 3 is 5. So 3 by 5. We know 3 by 5 is 60%. So 60% increase. Okay. You got the answer? In this session, I will give you the same concept but the different variety of questions they can ask. Okay. So the same concept how we will use. Okay. See, next question. If price of sugar is increased by 25%, but a family wants to keep its expenditure same as earlier, then they should decrease their consumption by how much percentage? See, very simple. See, we have to buy some sugar, okay, some quantity of sugar, and we have some price for it. So we have some expenditure. We have to give money to the shopkeeper, right? So there is some expenditure. So they are saying now the price of the sugar is increased by 25% from the previous one. So what will happen? The expenditure increases, but we have to retain the same expenditure. So the only possible way is we have to reduce the consumption, right? The quantity we buy. So that is what the concept here it is. So how much percentage we have to reduce the consumption? That is what the question is. Okay. I have substituted using the formula. You just look into it, but I'll say you the shortcut. See, 25% increase is nothing but 1 by 4 in fraction, right? So increase, which is equal to, keep the numerator same. Since it is increase, add the denominator and numerator. So 4 plus 1 is 5, which is a reduction in consumption. So we get 20%. So we have to reduce our consumption by 20%. Okay. See, the question stops here. They ask how much percentage we should reduce the consumption. If the question is like how many kg we have to find, we have to further go on with the answer, okay? So since the question is how much percentage we should reduce the consumption, we'll complete it by 20%. If they ask how many kgs, then we'll have to solve again, okay? That also we'll see. See, next question, you try to solve by yourself. If price of petrol is increased by 20%, then Mohan should cut down consumption by what percentage to keep his budget unchanged? Similarly, price given, consumption and expenditure. Expenditure should be kept as such. So consumption should be reduced. So 1 by 5 is nothing but 20%. So it is increased. So add 1, keeping the denominator 1 same. 5 plus 1, 6. Decrease. 1 by 6 is again 16.66%. Okay. See the next question. Coffee prices doubled, but we don't want to raise our expenditure. Then we should cut down our coffee consumption by what percentage? Here the percentage is not given. So initially, if we'll take the initial price as 100, right? 100%. Now it is doubled, which means 200%, which means increase of 100%, right? So 100% in fraction, it can be written as 1 by 1, right? So 1 by 1 increase. So right hand side, keeping the numerator as such, adding 1 to 1, which is 2. So 1 by 2 decrease, which is nothing but 50%. So we have to reduce our consumption by 50%. Hope you understood, right? See, next question. If the speed of a motorboat is decreased by 1/4, then journey completion time should increase by what percentage? See, here speed concept is used. Speed, distance, time. We know speed is equal to distance by time. Okay. So speed is decreased by 1/4. So initially it is 100%. So decreased by 1/4 means 1/4 of 100, which is nothing but 25%. So we need not convert it into percentage again. Just write it down as such. So 1/4 decrease. Okay. So we have to increase the journey time by what percentage is the question. So decrease, keep the numerator as such. 4 minus 1 is 3. So 1 by 3, we already know through the table, it is 33.33%. It's quite easy, right? See, next question. Mobile company increased the call charges by 50%. If I want to keep my budget unchanged, I should reduce talk time by what percentage? So 50% is nothing but 1 by 2 increase. Okay. So keeping the numerator as such, 1, 2 plus 1, 3. It is decreased. So talk time should be decreased by 33.33%. Okay. Next question. See, earlier UPSC used to ask 579 questions for 2900 marks. Now they want to decrease number of questions by 20%, but what to keep the total marks same as earlier? So they should increase the marks per question by what percentage? See, at times they will give you extra, which you don't want actually for the calculation, to confuse you. So you be clear what the concept is asked. Okay. Here, see, decrease the number of questions by 20%. Total marks should be same, but what should be changed? Increase the marks per question. Okay, so the same concept, 1 by 5 is nothing but 20% is 1 by 5 decrease. Okay, so increase of mark per question we have to find. So 1 by 5 decrease means keep the numerator 1, 5 minus 1 is 4, so which is 25%. Hope you understood. See, from next question, the same concept will be used, but in addition, we'll have to find some more values. See, the question, Dish TV has reduced the channel prices by 20%. Now, I am able to subscribe to 5 more channels in the same budget of rupees 400. How many channels did I subscribe earlier? So, they haven't asked any percentage here, but still, we'll have to find the percentage first. From the using that percentage, we'll calculate. See. The question is very simple. See, channel price they reduced by 20%. So, what is the advantage on reduction? We'll get extra channels, okay, on the same budget. So, price, consumption, expenditure. Write it down. Earlier, let us assume it to be 100. Since the channel price is reduced by 20%, let us consider it as 80, okay. Then consumption, we don't know how much. Let us consider it as X. Now, we get X plus 5, right? And expenditure is the same, 400 400. Now using the concept, we'll do what we'll do. 20% is 1 by 5 decrease, okay. So we'll get as 1 by 4 increase in the number of channels, that is 25% in increase of channels or consumption, okay. Now we have to find the X value, right? So 25% of X is equal to 5. How is this statement? It is nothing but 25% of X is equal to, we know they have given us 5 more channels, we'll get extra, okay. 25% of X is 1 by 4 of X, which is equal to 5. So X is equal to 20. So we'll have to find what is the earlier number of channels, 20. If the question is like, what is the number of channels right now, we are using 20 plus 5, 25 channels. So the question is, earlier, so we'll start with 20. Hope you understood. See, we'll see one more question. See, a man spends rupees 54 on apple every month, okay. Price of apple is decreased by 20% and this man can buy 10 apples more. What is the reduced price per dozen? Same concept. So 20% decrease means 1 by 5 decrease, so which is 1 by 4 increase, that is 25% extra he can buy, okay. So first we'll see, initially it is 100, okay, and 20% decrease means 80, price will be 80, okay. Consumption is X, okay, and here X plus 10 on the second stage, and expenditure is the same, 54 rupees, okay. So same concept previously what we have seen. So 25% of X is equal to 10, because he is able to get 10 extra apples, okay. 25% is 1 by 4 of X is equal to 10, so X is equal to 40. So earlier 40 apples he was able to get, and now 40 plus 10, which is 50 apples he is able to get, okay. So 50 apples is equal to 54 rupees at present. The question is, what is the reduced price per dozen? Dozen means 12, okay. So 12 apples is equal to how many rupees, which is nothing but 54, just cross multiply, for 54 into 12, which is equal to 50 into X. So X is equal to 54 into 12 by 50, finally you will get as 12.96 rupees, okay. See the next question, final question. A family spends rupees 600 on sugar everyone. The price of sugar is decreased by 20% and they are able to buy 5 kg sugar more. What was the original price of sugar per kg? See, try to solve it by yourself and finally check for the answer. And still I'll just explain you. See, price, consumption, expenditure. Write it as such. Initially 100%, okay, price. Now it is decreased by 20%, which means 80, okay. Consumption they haven't given, but now he is able to get plus 5, okay. Then expenditure is 600 600, okay. Now they are given the percentage as 20%, so 1 by 5 decrease, so it will lead to 1 by 4 increase, which is 25% of our consumption, okay. 25% of
Again, they have given 5 more kg extra he can buy. So 25% of x is equal to 5. So 1 by x is equal to 20. So the earlier consumption was 20 and now 20 plus 5, which is 25 kg. And the question is, what was the original price of sugar per kg? So we know price is, see, price into consumption is equal to expenditure. So price, if we need, bring the consumption down. So expenditure divided by consumption, which is equal to 600 by original price, right? So 20, okay? On cancelling, we get 30. So the price per kg, earlier it was 30, okay? Now, I'll just give you a gist on what we have seen. So, the questions will be like, if A is R percentage more than B, then B is less than A by what percentage, okay? There we'll use this concept. Then price of some commodity is increased by this percentage. So, how much the consumption can be reduced by keeping the budget or expenditure same? That kind of question, we'll use this concept. Then for salaries, okay? Then for weight, height, age, the age of son is this much percentage less than father. So, father is how much percentage greater than son? Okay, that is a kind of question. Then a number is this much percentage greater than the another number. So, the another number is this much percentage, how much percentage lesser than this number? Okay, then okay. Then we'll have to find the speed, this much percentage. Then mensuration, there we'll see the length of a rectangle is increased by this much percentage. So how much it must be reduced to keep the breadth as same. Okay, like these kind of questions, we will use this concept. Okay, so I hope you understood this concept. Try practicing more questions and do check out for these kind of questions and practice it. Definitely you can crack these kind of questions within seconds. So I hope you understood this concept. So use it and solve it very easily. And thank you for all the support given. Keep supporting. Do watch all the videos. I'll just give you the link in the description box. Thank you.